Welcome to the God Farm. Your God Farm. This is Al. At the God Farm, you're going to learn the meaning of your life and your destiny with God for eternity. You're going to learn what's been stopping you from the true meaning of life and how to get past those areas onto your forever journey so you can be face to face with God. We're going to mention this module's titled Traveling in the Spirit. It says in Colossians 3, 1-2, if then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on things on the earth. So the question is, can a person travel with their spirit without having like a near-death experience in it, like a car accident or dying on an operating table and coming back to life? Well, many years ago, I read in the Bible that Ezekiel was taken in the spirit to various places on earth. It says in Ezekiel 43:5, the spirit lifted me up and brought me into the inner court, and behold, the glory of the Lord filled the temple. And also in Ezekiel 3:14-15, it says, so the spirit lifted me up and took me away, and I went in bitterness in the heat of my spirit. But the hand of the Lord was strong upon me. Then I came to the captives at Tel Abib, who dwelt by the river Chebar, and I sat where they sat and remained there astonished among them 7 days. We also see that Elisha moved in the spirit when he said in 2 Kings 5:28, but Elisha asked him, don't you realize that I was there in spirit when Naaman stepped down from his chariot to meet you? And we see that Paul also says in Colossians 2:5, for though I be absent in the flesh, yet I am with you in the spirit. And John also traveled in the spirit. He said in Revelation 1:10, I was in the spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice as of a trumpet. And also in Revelation 4:2, he said, immediately I was in the spirit. In Revelation 17:3, he said, so he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness. And in Revelation 21:10, he said, and he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain. It showed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of the heaven from God. I realized many years ago that I could see people were traveling in the spirit, but I didn't understand how this could be possible. Nobody ever talked about this. No one ever mentioned anything like this to me before. So I ended up tracking down some Christians who were doing this and got together with them in various countries. And at first, I didn't know quite what they were doing, as they didn't teach about how to do this traveling in the spirit or how to go in the spirit. They just expected me to do it. I hoped something from them would rub off on me, but I just wasn't getting it. So I said to God, I wanted more of this. And I told God, I said, frankly, if I'm not going to get this and I'm not going to have this, then no sense in me staying here on earth anymore. I didn't want any more of this world. I wanted to be operating in the supernatural realm. I looked at it like I was spiritually disabled, really. And I was serious. And I said, God, if you can't bring me into this experience and ability, then you might as well just take me home right now. God didn't hit me with lightning and I didn't die, so I figured, well, I guess more is coming then, and it did. And God pointed out to me with his keys on how to do this and start visiting many places on earth in the spirit, as well as visiting into heaven. Now, a lot of people are confused about spiritual travel. They think it's like the New Age astral projection, and they think this is something that's evil because witches do it. Well, there are differences between astral projection, as non-Christians, let's say, call it. There's differences between that and bilocation, being two places at the same time or traveling in the Spirit with God. Those who are involved in astral projection say, I've never done that myself, but those who say they engage in astral projection say they are usually sleeping or in some kind of a meditative sleep state, and they start to feel vibrations or energy. They hear loud noises, they become disoriented, and they usually feel fear throughout the experience. They say that they usually travel close to their physical body, such as floating in their bedroom or over an operating table or over a car wreck that they were in. These practitioners and near-death experience researchers report that a silver cord is seen connecting the spirit and physical body. They say that returning to their physical body can be violent and abrupt. We see those we just talked about, Ezekiel, Elisha, Paul, and John in the Bible. They weren't sleeping. They weren't in a sleep state. They didn't report any of these sensations I just talked about. And they also traveled into heaven, 2 Corinthians 12:2. So in my experiences and those of other Christians that I've talked to, traveling in the spirit is a wide awake event. There's no weird sensations. There certainly isn't any fear. It can take place while you're sleeping. The main difference is God. I trust by now that we can all agree that God created everything. Isaiah 43:10-11. Before me there was no God formed, nor shall there be after me. I am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. So he gave us the free will to run our lives with him or without him. We can accomplish certain tasks with him, and we can do things without him. When we pursue his kingdom first in our lives, as it says in Matthew 6:33, this is a major key. He will allow us to do many things, such as come visit him in heaven. When people decide that they can do things on their own, that they don't need or want God, they can still move their physical and spiritual body at will, but visiting with God and going to heaven isn't on the list. In the spiritual realm, without God, a person's spirit has limitations. Astral projectors can and do run into dark or evil forces while moving around the spiritual realm. For some of them, such as witches, this is their goal. They want to work with demons. So really, when you play with fire, then these people shouldn't be surprised when they get burned. God can take people for a limited trip to a small part of heaven, such as people experience near-death experiences. He does this to teach them or show them something before they are sent back to their physical bodies. Many have reported that they were a non-Christian before their near-death experience, when they met Jesus or an angel or a deceased relative while they were. Operating in the spirit, with their spirit. And when they came back to life, they reported their experience, became a Christian, and altered their life. I really never heard of a new near-death experience person ever going back for a second visit with God or heaven, though. I've also never heard of anyone who astral projects without God, or any astral projectors. I've never heard of anyone who said that they've met with God or visited heaven. God tells us in his word that they can't. They can see, astral projectors, they can see and move around the spirit realm, but they're not allowed in heavenly realms. Similarly, Satan can move around in the spiritual realm, and demons as well, but he doesn't have access to levels in heaven. It frankly, it wouldn't be heaven with him in it, even if he was just for a visit. He attends spiritual court sessions convened by God, but they are held in a separate area of the spiritual realm. The Bible is very plain that only certain people are allowed access to God in heaven. We see in Hebrews 12:14, it says, "Pursue peace with all people in holiness, without which no one will see the Lord." And 3 John 1:11 says, "Beloved, do not imitate what is evil, but what is good. He who does good is of God, but he who does evil has not seen God." God says here, those who do not seek God's holiness or do evil cannot see him. And it says in Ephesians 2:18, "For through him we both have access by one Holy Spirit to the Father." So God says here that we have access to him, the Father, through the Holy Spirit right now. We can't get to heaven through being good or doing good works or taking our own paths, as we see in Ephesians 2:8-9. "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast." So this means any set of morals or value system or religion or life plan that a person designs may look and sound good, but it's not the path that you're supposed to be on. Astral projecting or traveling in the spirit without Jesus, without God's holiness, practicing evil won't get you visiting him or heaven. So let's talk about bilocation. It's an expression that people sometimes use for traveling or going somewhere in their spirit. As your physical body is in one place and your spirit body is in another. Some might say, well, how can you think and operate in two places or more at the same time? Well, we know we can multitask subconsciously. For example, you can be steering a car, watching for obstacles, maintaining a certain speed level, listening to music, talking to passengers, drinking some coffee, breathing. All of this you can be doing at the same time. And also your internal organs and systems are working without you even thinking about them. It's common to think and function on many levels. God has created us in as a wonderful soul mind that can accomplish a great many things, that can operate our physical bodies and our spiritual light bodies independently of each other. Some people call this experience a rapture or an ecstasy or, again, going in the spirit. Visits are sometimes known as a trance when some experience or they might be oblivious to what's going on around them and then they come back. Many of the monks of old, like those, like the Desert Fathers and Mothers who taught me a great deal, they spent regular time in every day in the spirit with God and in heaven. Many today call these people Christian mystics. Rhoda and I both go all over the world in the spirit. Rhoda, for instance, goes with Jesus to many places around the world to heal people, giving them new limbs and raising the dead. She's there in an instant. As I said, we are of God and part of God, and we are not created light. We are of the Creator, and we can therefore travel at the speed of thought. So it's going in the spirit is extremely fast, and I realized many years ago when I was going in the spirit about. And I thought, you know, I thought it was so great that I was doing all this. And then one day I read where Jesus said in Matthew 18:20, "For where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there in the midst of them." And Jesus said this before he died. And I thought, well, Jesus must have been in a lot of places at the same time. So I thought, and there's no other way for him to accomplish this other than his spirit having the ability to multitask and go in different locations. And Jesus said, "Most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me The works that I do, he will do also, and greater works than these he will do.
If you'd like to learn more about these amazing teachings that will radically change your life, please go to thegodfarm.com, scroll down, and register there. See you soon.